okay, sorry guys and sorry girls, we love you guys out there, but there just comes a time when it just all has got to crumble and come to an end. Last show. Now, we're going to have top five best moments that I had to choose from. Like, I mean, we're talking like at least a lot of fucking shit. Couple, like a whole list. So, I'm not going to really reveal what we're like pretty much going to fucking like show for you guys. But it's all fun. We love you guys, man. Last show, right? This is it. Fucking feel like crying. Been having like nightmares and shit, dude. Like the end of television is just like almost done. Like we're talking like the end of television is almost like at our fucking doorstep. Like we're talking like right here, right now, this is it. Like no more. But I guess we're gonna still be over there for you guys on YouTube, right.com. So you can search Movie Collectors Music Show. So keep that in mind. Movie Collectors Music Show. It's more important, you know. Robert Gonzales, I don't know if we're gonna go through all that, but YouTube.com though, we're right there still for you guys, live via satellite. We still got all kinds of good shit for you guys, right? Isn't that like, oh my god. We've been through a shitload of shit, dude. So you guys can go through our like history of bands we've been with. Go through the history of all the 500 TV shows plus that we've done. I mean, we taped some pretty badass bands. DRI was like the highlight. We've got bands like fucking U.S. Bombs. Then we played U.S. Bombs. Them guys are pretty fucking badass, dude. Some other bands here and there, you know. Body Part Rain. Fucking Room. But I think we got... Do I want to talk about 1997? Fucking hell. Okay, so I think we got now Phantom Menace. We're going to show this for you guys, right? So, hopefully you guys are going to enjoy this footage. Went through a lot to film it for you guys. I mean, we had to like sit through all this footage to kind of like come up with the best. And if you ask me, this is the best. Right here, right now, me fucking playing this DRI song with this. I wish she was right here, like with me hugging. I was hugging her, but she's okay. Her pictures were okay. It rocks. But it's gonna be fucking fun. I'm like really enjoying like knowing that we can provide all this old footage for you guys. I mean, we are digging in our roots, right? We're digging into the fucking nitty gritty of old shit. There was a lot to choose from, but some of these, they are definitely the best. Maybe somebody out there might make the differ, but we don't care. You know what I'm saying? So we're like over there in Grant Road, if I'm not mistaken, off of like I-10 in Tucson, Arizona. So that's where we were at when the theater, I think the theater still kicks over there still. So it's just been a while since I've been around over there. But off of Grand Road, we were over there videotaping the introduction of, or the first showings of Star Wars Phantom Menace. Fucking 1997. We were there. The fucking news was there. So you guys are going to see all that footage too. It's awesome. So I got a segment of like five different shows. I guess I can probably say that right now. So fuck it, you know what I mean? First, 1997, fucking Phantom Menace, Tucson, Arizona. We were live via satellite over there, interviewing fucking random people. It was cold as fuck, dude. I'm surprised I didn't see too many different costumes, right? You think? Well, probably would've been better. Oh, but I got fucking Star Wars Downtown Joliet Now, I wanted Joliet's fucking goddamn fucking was thinking about Star Wars Joliet when we filmed that downtown Joliet stuff. You guys go to the web pages. I think you can be able to see all that. YouTube.com or something like that. So, search Movie Collectors Music Show. Stay tuned for the Rooster Show.
TV guys. Via satellite, fucking in the fucking theater.
They're doing their corporate thing here. We're doing our
NBC is live via satellite with us too. So here we are. This is our private own news here. See, you should just look behind us.
Yeah, see, they're doing their news here. We're doing our news here.
So here you have it, guys. You guys who are seeing this right now, it's not really happening show. So. There they are hosting their own TV show while we're broadcasting this shit.
That's KVOA, people. So, wow.
This is awesome. So, as you saw already, Tucson, Arizona, there's a lot of people here as you go around the corner over there. And we even got the newscasters here, too, at the same motherfucking time.
Yep.
Skywalker, the father of Luke, who will eventually turn into darkness. And here I am.
Yeah, are you going to use this in case someone tries to pass it online? Yeah. Pass line?
Whoever touches that ticket before me is going to feel the wrath of the Force right here.
And how about you guys? You brought a sign. Tell me about this.
Yeah, it's my Darth Maul sign right here. My Anakin Skywalker can, you can only get these exclusively from Pepsi. I don't know if we should advertise that. These are personally mine, though. I'm a big fan. Here's my shirt, too. Darth Maul, he's my... I mean, I haven't seen anything yet of him yet, but he's already driving me crazy. So.
We're here for the Century Park screen of Episode 1, Phantom Menace, Star
First
Wars.
Day.
We're here.
We're going to interview people now.
I was here at midnight last night, though, so it's like the second day.
Yo. Yeah, that's my same shirt.
Yo.
You're the only person I've seen who has that shirt.
Welcome to the Rob's D2 Show. I'm the host, Rob's D2. I'm here live via satellite, Century Park.
Tell me you're off of Grant. Giving people flyers.
Yo, Doc, you can pass some flyers out if you want. How you guys doing today? You guys ready for the Star Wars thing? Oh yeah, me too. I already saw it, by the way. It's bad, dude. I still got like about six more times I gotta see it. I'm still stoked for this shit, man. I was here last night at midnight. You guys should just tell my story.
This is his new home now.
So now I'm here filming. When I should have been here filming when there was hundreds of people here, but I was one of those people that were like waiting, so. How about you, sir? I know you from somewhere. Where I know you from? Oh, that's right. This is a guy who collects. He's a collector, a guy collector here. I collect all the Star Wars stuff that's been coming out over at Pizza Hut. What's it called? Taco Bell. I've been up since last night, dude. All night long, so you got to break it. But, cool.
Oh, that's cool.
How you like the movie so far? Huh? Are you excited to go into and watch it? Have you seen it yet? How about the old movies? Have you seen the old movies a lot? Who's your favorite character in the old movies?
I don't know.
You don't like Chewbacca or the Ewoks? There's one of our future stars there.
Thank you for being here tonight. Hopefully everybody enjoyed all that wonderful footage. Keep in mind, we had the news over there. Now, we didn't really call the news, but it was pretty cool that the news was there. One of the spontaneous moments, you know what I'm saying, that ended up coming down and rocked the YouTube Movie Collector's music show history. Fucking, that was a lot of fun. Phantom Menace, man, you know. I mean, we had been waiting years for that to come out. But came out and it was fun and it passed and shit, and now we just, that's our memories of it. So it's pretty cool to have all that footage and you know, have all the memories. How much fun we were having. Excited for Star Wars coming back out. I wasn't too fond on Jar Jar Binks, but fucking Jar Jar. I think number four, we got Night of the Living Dead, or Night of the Doll.
Yo soy Diablo! Yo soy Diablo!
So, you guys get ready for Night of the Doll pretty soon, right? So, hopefully everybody's gonna enjoy this little bit of footage that we captured for you guys, too. It was at my finest, almost. Like, I was thinking and telling the producer here, or the director here, I was like, look, I can't believe how much fucking effort we used to put into putting all these shows together back then. We actually went on location, filmed the little things like the cave and the stupid, you know, the fucking Night of the Living fucking Doll. Best work. I have a good fucking, you know, I have a good feeling that when we come on with the next ones, which are going to be pretty soon, they're gonna be pretty fucking choice shit. So, I think Night of the Living Doll. We only got a couple minutes of this. Hopefully everybody's been enjoying the TV show. We got a whole hour for you guys, so hopefully this is the last of the last. Once again, I guess we got a fucking awesome Miss Nettles, right, don't we? Holy fuck, let me see. Last show. Top 5 moments. So, coming up for you guys next is part, well, it's like we're going down from 5 to 4 to the best spot, number 1. So, number 4, we got Night of the Living Doll, Night of the Doll. It was pretty fucking fun putting it together, so we gotta admit, man, low budget, you guys will see, but it just was fucking alive, we were keeping it real. Completely keeping it fucking real, man, you know what I'm saying? I mean, we had I don't even remember what we were using for equipment. How I was able to, like, see that shit back and, you know, fucking, see some kind of, like, what you guys are going to be able to see. The little story of the Night of the Doll. I wish I had a fucking poster. I think we have a poster here somewhere. I'm gonna have to have a real poster of my Night of the Doll, dude, you know what I'm saying? Where it's like,
Yo soy el Diablo.
Yeah, it was like, oh my god, yeah, totally. Yo soy fucking Diablo, all I got to say. So, Night of the Living Doll, hopefully everybody's gonna enjoy it tonight. You know, like I said, we were live via satellite. From a long time ago, 1997, you guys, I'm just going to just mention this real quick. That was a pretty fun time. Phantom Menace, it kicked ass. It was cool. Star Wars rocks. Keep on watching Star Wars, everybody out there. Get ready for Night of the Doll, though. Show number 4, we got this for you guys. It's just the best of. This is almost the last of the last, so we're trying to, try to do it right for y'all. Show you guys some kick-ass footage. The best of the best. We had a big ass list I had to set aside because it was just fucking almost couldn't fucking look at that fucking list no more. So, but got my new list, number 3, coming out for you guys. Enjoy this for now though, right? Night of the Doll.
get you. Yes, I will get you. I am El Diablo. I am the devil doll. The doll.
Yo soy el Diablo. 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 Soy Diablo. Yo 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 soy el 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 Diablo. Soy el Diablo. Yo 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 soy el Diablo.
Holy shit.
Yo soy el Diablo.
Holy shit.
Yo soy el Diablo.
Help! Help!
Yo soy el Diablo.
Get me. Get me. Ah! 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 He's gonna get me. No! Ah!
Soy el Diablo. Yo 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 soy el Diablo.
Fuck, man. Fuck. Son of a bitch.
God damn, we're fucking kidding. Son of a bitch. Fuck. Fuck. Son of a bitch. Yo soy el Diablo. 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 Yo soy el Diablo.
Fuck. Fuck.
Yo soy el Diablo. 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 yo soy le-
I mean, I don't know if you guys can see my shirt, but it's A Nightmare on Elm Street. Very cool movie. I highly recommend it for anybody that's out there that's going ahead and just like get into like horror flicks. Nightmare on Elm Street was pretty fucking fun. Fun movie to watch. Inspired me completely for the
Night of the Doll.
So if anybody enjoyed that, right? I mean, like I said, we were on fire back then. I don't know what the fuck happened to my magic and my fucking trick that I was trying to just do. Sometimes I think lack of fucking equipment was like our problem sometimes too. You know what I'm saying? We gotta have a camera and shit, you know. Can't really record nothing. Just, you know, can't capture moments when you ain't got the right equipment to capture the damn motherfucking moments with. But, Night of the Fucking Doll was like one of my fucking best films, little short films put together. Took us a long time. Clark Gable fucking actor, or the doll, rocks. I wish I got that, man. You know, God rest my soul. God rest my uncle. That's who it was. And he passed away a long time ago. But it was his fucking doll, dude. That shit was badass. I don't know why we just didn't keep it anyways. And I should have just asked him for it. That probably would have been better. Yeah, dude, this doll's a classic. This doll's a hit, dude. This doll's made like 100 fucking, like we're talking like flyers throughout the whole area. Night of the Doll. I thought, do we have like a title for that too? Intro and shit.
Curse of El Diablo.
Curse of El Diablo, no shit. So, I think in a few minutes we're gonna keep. I don't think in a few minutes. We're gonna have some garage days for you guys coming up next. So hopefully you guys be able to enjoy these kind of precious moments. Sick, very. Almost like wasn't like so much like we were showing too much crazy shit, but times are fucking changing. We just thought that a lot of this shit that was in these episodes of all the whole, you know, the Movie Collectors Music Show, what we all were trying to represent and let you guys see what the hell was going on from like the real point of view. I mean, we couldn't get no real than that. Holy fuck, it was kind of scary. But we did it. So there's some garage days, some pirate head stuff. It's fucking funny. Mike rapping, badass classic shit. Allie, oh, you guys will see Allie. You'll see. That's all I gotta say about that. She's a good friend of mine. Worked for me over at Burger King many, many moons ago. Pretty fucking fun. Very, very beautiful woman. Could you imagine how she looks right now? Damn. Probably smoking. But we're going to show some garage taste for you guys. Hopefully you guys would like it. You know what I'm saying? It was number 3 of our pick. My pick for best rock to moments for you guys. For like, we're talking like, this is it, dudes. Like, you ain't going to get no more than this no more. This is fucking it. You find us on MySpace. So right, or YouTube, so you can go to youtube.com, search either Robert Gonzales, which you don't want to really want to fucking search Robert Gonzales, but definitely Movie Collectors Music Show, definitely more important. So this has been the last shows of top moments and shit, you know what I'm saying? We're all YouTubed out now, dudes. This is all over the fucking place now, guys, girls especially. Fucking garage days, huh? So we got garage days. I mean, ouch. Pretty fucking creepy. Pretty fucking fun though, man. Fucking, like I said, we were all a big old fucking family and shit. We all took care of each other and shit. Had a bunch of fucking fun. This is a lot of bunch of kick-ass music. Lived it real. We were all living it real, baby. You know what I'm saying? Nobody find too any offense that we saying, if we were having to fucking say fucking stupid shit and anybody find any offense to it, doesn't matter anyways. Shit still got aired out back then, it's still gonna air out right now. But we got garage days for you guys. Get ready. Right.
This is my second hand, homie. She's playing a little earring.
Arrrrr, it's Eddie Givers, fuck me bridges.
So anyways, Tucson, that's my pirate matey.
Arrrr, Jeremy Timbers!
I just don't want to be over here. I don't want to get out of here.
One day you would say that's just how I felt. But I'm sick and tired of haters multiplying by the dozen. Always running your mouth and making something out of nothing. Always fronting on other people, but just for no reason. Come my way, I'll make sure you ain't breathing. Looks like deceiving, like in every way, shape, and form. Just because you won some battles doesn't mean you'll win the war. The walls are closing in and the water's getting deep. Trying to do what we can to survive up in these streets. People die and cry over cash and jewelry. But how can you kill something they can't see? But I'm trapped in the field with a hand-like and skills. Cause in this cold world, it's either kill or be killed. But the devil appears up in this final stage. Time to strike first, let the fucking games take place. Gotta step through the hate, the pain, and the suffering. But those who didn't make it and the ones that did, I'm gonna stick and move. Then I gotta bob and weave. All I know one day might have a little mouth to feed. One of us got to bleed. Either you or me, then I know you're gonna go down on the count of three. And I put that on the G and the world and the seven C's. By the way, my name is M-I-K to the fucking E. I flow every single way, 7 days a fucking week. And while I'm doing that, I'm smoking beats with Swisher Sweets. So bring the static and I'll send your ass back in a closed casket with your head cracked open with a note saying how it happened.
Oh shit!
Yeah. Hold on, wait, let me switch
characters. Yeah! Alright, Mikey! This guy needs his only fucking hour because he's a fucking genius.
No, take
fucking hour, I swear to God. There may be about fucking dozen of you motherfuckers out there that don't even like this guy, but you know what? I like him, and if you don't like him, fuck you. You fucking suck. But you know what? This dude's fucking funny as fuck, Tucson. Yeah, like you know, I mean, like literally, not only does he look funny, but he is actually a really fucking comedic fucking person. I don't like you fucking...
Dude, I just can't...
Oh yeah, Tucson, check it out.
Wait, dude. Get a close-up on this motherfucking door right now. Stand up.
Come on, dude.
Yeah, come on, Tucson.
This is what happens when Tucson, Arizona drivers ride in Chicago, all right? This is what happens. All right, you cactus slickers got to remember, when you start a manual truck, you take it out of gear, you know what I'm saying? And then put your foot on a little square thing that's the brake and then the clutch, you know what I mean? You push them both in, then you turn the key and your car won't go nowhere, you know what I mean? But Robert didn't know that shit, you know what I mean?
I fucked it up, I'm sorry.
This door. Now, just to me, it does not an optical illusion. This is really crooked as fuck. But the door don't even go like, look at that shit. You know what I mean? Like, watch this shit.
So
what? What the fuck is that? You know what I mean? Look, do this one more time. Ready? Watch this shit. Oh, see that? Look at that shit. What is that? All right, now this is like this, right? Now come outside. Come here. Hold on, let me show you the whole premises. Come here, take this out. Now look at this motherfucker right here. Look down. Can you see anything down here? Alright, look at this corner. Get this corner right here. On this side of it. That's the inside of my garage. You know what I'm saying, dude? This motherfucker hit this bitch with a truck. Not a car. This truck right here. Look at this truck right here. This motherfucking truck right here. This kid put right in my motherfucking garage, dude. At 5 o'clock in the morning. Now that's some cactus looking shit right there, you know what I'm saying?
You wanna know why I feel sorry for her the most?
Why, Robert?
Well, because she fucking works for her and she knows me. She knew me. Okay, one day I went into work all fucked up, right? Fucking drank like a half a bottle of some old ass fucking grandpa's fucking whiskey.
Yeah.
Man, fuck me up, dude. I fucking rode my bike all the way from fucking right here on 80th Avenue all the way to fucking Frankfurt to our job. Film her. Gotta get her in this.
Burger King.
Get us both in her. Yeah, so I get to fucking work and I'm fucked up, man. You know, I rode all the way from here, it's about a good, 2 miles, huh?
Yeah, probably.
2 miles,
So I ride my bike and I get there and it's freezing outside too, right? It's fucking snow. And I couldn't even ride down the fucking stupid bike path that was frozen over.
I've never seen that before.
But I was wasted, man. Got to fucking work. Then Karen shows up there and she's, I don't know what the fuck she told me, but I was like, oh fuck, what the fuck are you doing here? Get out of here, I'm fucked up, I gotta go to work. And she's like, oh, look at you, you're all faded. And I'm like, yeah, so what? But I gotta work. I think this interview is almost probably over, though.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this is Allie, Tucson, Arizona, one of my best friends almost. I consider her a best friend. She probably hates me, though. But we want you guys to fucking know who the hell I hang out with, and this is one of them. So, thanks for the interview, my friend. Appreciate it.
No problem.
So that was Allie, Tucson, Arizona, so we'll be back in a little while for you, kid. Peace.
Once again, hopefully you guys are enjoying the music. I mean, a whole lot of DRI for you guys today and tonight, right? Hell, fuck it, man. Shit. Guess now, Garage Day's done. So, hopefully everybody thought that was pretty funny. Now, we thought it was a lot of fun back then. Now, we were having all kinds of damn fun. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't about no damn hoe thing. We weren't selling no women or anything like that and shit. But the women were having all kinds of fun too. It was badass. The garage days, we would call those. So, Michael Beard, I don't think who the hell he called himself anymore. He was like Mr. Reed back then, wasn't he?
Yeah. Really like out the trunk records?
Yeah, dude, that shit was fucking choice. Now, I don't know who fucking thought fucking Mike Mystery was kind of like rocking and bumping, but he was bumping back time. Shit, you can go to youtube.com and you can search Movie Collectors Music Show. Most important, that's it. Movie Collectors Music Show, youtube.com. You will find more of our shit. We're out here for you guys, live via satellite, everywhere like our heart desires, because we videotape everything that like we fucking do, and not even take a shit. But YouTube, select the shows, 5 best moments, coming down to a couple more. Shit, what do we got next? Denver? Oh shit. Best part of the whole fucking, it was almost like one of them highlights again, you know what I'm saying? Seriously, highlight. Like, almost like, what more can we do more that's gonna show everybody and our viewers out there, everybody who really has been here all this whole time, listen to what the fuck I'm saying. And I'm not trying to be like a big fucking mouth and say, oh yeah, like I fucking really know everything. I'm only trying to be your guys' friend out there, because anybody who sit out there and watch us, what the hell we done and what the fuck we've been doing, being out here for you guys, going on location. We've been on a lot of locations and shit, huh? A lot of locations. We got all kinds of shit still coming up. I'm gonna try to get some Danica Patrick. I don't even know if we got pit passes. We gotta find out. We can get autograph. We gotta find out where the autograph session is. YouTube.com. Search Movie Collectors Music Show. That's Movie Collectors Music Show. Very important if you want to, like, you know, see the shows on YouTube, right? So, YouTube.com, go over there. You guys will be able to see us over there. Last of the shows, you'll still be able to see us anyways, no matter what. We're going and moving, like, forward now. We fucking gotta wait. This is it. Next shows, YouTube. It's gonna be awesome. We're gonna have a lot of shit for you guys. We're going all over the fucking place, man. We're all over Chicago, man. We're all over everything in between to here in Tucson. We're just like on this, like, almost like a magical mystery, fucking like magical mystery tour and shit, right? Is that what it's called? Having all kinds of fun. YouTube.com. Go to Movie Collectors Music Show, people, so you can see more of our shit. So, for the most part, fucking, we're going to Denver trip. baseball game episodes. Or, oh yeah, oh my god, the edibles. Watch the edibles, see if you can see the changes of the edibles. 2014, that was the year, it was fun. Stay tuned, Arizona, Denver. See you guys in a few more minutes. Okay, Tucson, the world. Fuck, I'm fucking driving, dudes. For once, I'm fucking driving. Nah, just kidding. I actually drive a lot, believe it or not, you guys. Drive every fucking wheel. We go from one side of the United States to the fucking other. Believe me, I gotta get behind the wheel a lot of times than probably anybody probably could think. So, we're still on a little road trip for Colorado. We're more than halfway there. We're at least at 75% there. So, we'll be getting out of Nebraska pretty soon, coming into Colorado, probably in the next hour or so. So I just wanted to say a couple words, let everybody know that I do know how to drive. It's not that hard. Plus, I'm driving a badass Impala. Woo! Sedgwick, this is Colorado. We're finally in the, we're here. We made it. Sedgwick Alternative Relief, okay? 107 Main Avenue. Hours Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. So we made really good timing. We were kind of expecting to get here a little bit later, but we made it. One Edgewater, Colorado. Here's a little sticker they gave us. Here's a Northern Lights business card. Bam. So we actually finally made our little fucking trip. Beer and loading to fucking Denver, Colorado. It's badass. Fucking got Denver right behind me over here. We're a little bit on the outskirts over there. We've got a new lake right by us. We ain't too far from the area too for where we can stay in though, but we made it. Edgewater. We got recommended for a place and fuck, I don't even remember the place no more, what it was called, but so much for them. They needed a medical card, this place didn't. Denver rocks, and all I gotta say is I wanna move here now. So I get badass bug every day, what I want, how I want, that's the bottom line. We made it though. There's Denver back there, people, check it out. Okay, Tucson, the whole world, we made it to Denver, here it is. We've been everywhere so far, all over the place. We shopped all kinds of badass weed shops. I think a couple, like I think we'll be able to show some of the weed that we bought because we bought some pretty good shit. But here's Denver. Denver, here we go. All the whole Denver area. Hey. Hola, yo. Sunday, April 6th, 2014, Colorado Coors Field. I want to say stadium. Here we are, over here, Arizona fucking versus Colorado Rockies. Look at, we got Arizona's up right now. Maybe we might get a hit. We're really not too sure. But for the most part, here we are, we made it. This has been a part of the whole trip of fear and loathing to Denver. On the Sunday afternoon, on the 6th, 2014, you know, they had a three-game series, which Colorado Rockies beat them on two games. That was today, Sunday, so that was Friday and Saturday. And today on Sunday, they just got beat. So, well, for the most part now, we've been right here, live, on location. Look at this, too, right here. Let's look at this. So, Colorado Rockies got defeated
again
by Arizona Diamondbacks. But look at the stadium for the Colorado Rockies. Really cool. Really nice, a little bit of like the downtown area. We've had so much fun. Still, as I speak, this is still simulated, so don't think that I'm right here, actually in Denver, at the Colorado Rockies, Coors Stadium. I'm not really here, it's all simulated. Back to you at the studio, Robert. Bye-bye.
Yeah, let's show you the Northern Lights stuff. Now, let's edit this right now. Here you go.
Dump it out, or?
Yeah. Here's the Northern Lights stuff, which when you smoke it, kind of makes you look like it's Northern Lights. Very nice, very tasty. It's Northern Lights, what it's called. Oh, from Northern Lights. Here, let's put this back. Every piece, every morsel is like very, very important. This is a kosher kush. It's a type of indica, right? And it says, have an incredible New Year's. Cannibal infused white chocolate with pop rocks, net weight 45 grams, lab tested 100 mg THC. So we got, this is an edible, one of the edibles. Fear and loathing. Peace.
This has been the best of the five for you guys. Hopefully you guys have been enjoying all this whole hour of all these good times that we've been having filming for you guys. We've come a long ways to filming. We're talking like 500 TV shows later, right? Or something like that. Like, that's a lot of fucking TV shows, man. A lot of fucking time sitting in front of a fucking camera. Like, I don't care what anybody fucking says. To spend that much fucking time talking to a fucking camera, like I'm talking in front of this camera right here tonight. Ends up finishing this shit tonight. I'm fucking telling you guys, I gotta be out of my fucking mind talking to a goddamn fucking camera. But I still do, it's fucking pretty fucking fun. Hopefully everybody's been enjoying this after all these fucking years. We're done. I think we're almost done. This has been like the last show's top five moments. I think public access is pretty much close to being done, right? So, we've been doing the top five best moments of our actual doing TV shows after all these years with everybody's help down in the studios over there in Tucson, Arizona, down with all the help over here in Illinois fucking studios, because I mean some people think that this is just like really fucking like you like just put out a camera and just shoot and there's your fucking footage. There's a shitload of shit. You gotta deal with the fucking lighting. You gotta deal with the cats hanging out. Music. There's a shitload of shit to fucking do. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed that little bit of footage of Denver shit. Hopefully I'm not gonna get in trouble. Probably not, but who cares. Yeah, we went to Arizona. It was Arizona versus Colorado Rockies, right? Baseball game, that was like in 2014. I don't really want to mention too much of a trip that was, but it was pretty fucking trippy. Edibles, that's all I gotta say. Edibles were fucking great. The edibles rock. Our first stop over there was, and I think I got a little bit of footage of Sedgwick. That was pretty fucking fun. We got really let down. Long as motherfucking story. We had drove like 13 fucking hours. How long the fucking ass. Trying to get the fucking super goddamn Colorado. Right? And fucking finally get the fucking stupid Sedgwick. And we were fucking highly let down. And it really did fucking suck. So, it was a long ass story. Anybody out there who wants to fucking know more about that fucking story, good luck finding it out. But, Sidwick was pretty fucking fun. I think now we got fucking DRI coming up for you guys. So, that was my choice of number one highlights of the best times. Because I think that's what this is. Last show's top five moments. Highlight, the end. What was that happened with DRI? Who knows? We fucking lost DRI. Just wasted too much fucking time. So, we got an interview with Spike Cassidy. But Spike Cassidy of DRI was one of my best all-time favorite moments of all of this, what I do for you guys. All of this, what we even fucking bother even for. You know what I'm saying? I didn't even know why even bother? Sometimes I ask myself, but we do it anyways. Waste a bunch of fucking time. Freak a lot of fucking people out. You know what I'm saying? But I think we're coming up to now. Enjoy it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the Denver trip, but that's done, right? So now fucking get ready for DRI. Dirty Rotten Imbeciles, if anybody remembers them out there. One of my best moments. One of my best times. Like, we're talking like, I mean, you can still go to our webpage. Not webpage, it's a youtube.com now. Just tap in Movie Collectors Music Show. I think you can see the history of the whole thing, right? Or something like that. Just tap into that shit. Movie Collectors Music Show. So get that straight. On youtube.com, because we're trying to be all over here. Now we're all over the place for you guys. Tucson-wide, Arizona-wide, now we're worldwide. So, you guys, DRI, fucking A. That's all I gotta say, right? Enjoy.
How you doing? My name is Robert. I'm Rob T. DeCiccio, Movie Collectors Music Show, and I'm here live via satellite at Rialto Theater to do the interview with DRI. Tonight we've already witnessed, so far, the band DRI, and we're about to do an interview with them, so if you want to just follow us this way, we're going to do the interview with the band. And it was a great one, that's for sure.
Oh,
it's the Route to D2
show.
It's the Route to D2 show. Route to, yeah, this guy right here. So, once again, we're going to do the interview with DRI here, live via satellite at Rialto Theater. We got the sync guitar player right here, Spike Lee, the man, guitar player of the band right here. Rob's the name?
Hey!
Here we are, Rob DeCiccio, my friend. Here we are. Finally, we made it, guys. How was the show? Did you guys enjoy yourself?
Yes, I had a great time.
Awesome, awesome. So how's the band been these days, you guys?
Terrible. We hate each other. We're going to break up tomorrow. Besides that, we'll keep going for another 20 years.
Yeah, that's for sure, huh? How about the new material? How's that treating you guys these days, man?
Okay, we were working on a few new songs right now. We played one tonight. We're looking for a new record label in the meantime, and once we get that all done, taken care of, then we'll put out something new.
The tour, so it's been kind of a little sketchy or something like that, or how's the tour been, your tour been?
The tour's great, thanks to somebody named John Finberg and First World Talent, who has completely made a great success of this tour.
Awesome, awesome. How about you're an old school for Tucson? You guys are from Tucson?
Yes.
Somebody is from Tucson.
No.
Okay, well, we had one of you guys a few years ago go visit Cholla High School. So we want to know what's the deal with that.
I don't know anything about that.
Okay, that's okay.
Sorry.
That's all right.
But we like Tucson.
That's for sure.
We have great shows here. We start tours here and end tours here.
What do you think of the music these days? That's, you know what I mean?
I like some of it. I don't like the commercial radio shit that much. There's a few bands out there that I still like them.
Well, for us, could you say maybe here, you know, this is brought to you, Spike Lee or Spike from DRI, brought to you the show.
And what are we watching here?
We were watching the Route to D2 show. This is Spike Lee. Watch Route to the Forbidden Zone on Access Tucson.
Rob to and the Forbidden.
Yeah.
Two television shows separate.
Should I separate the
probably get a new separate one.
The IDs then? So, Rob 2 is one?
That's me.
Okay. Hey, this is Spike from DRI, and you're watching Rob 2. Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Don't turn that channel.
Awesome.
And the other one is the Forbidden Zone?
Zone, yeah. That's we're supposed to be on right now. We are on right now.
Oh, we're on live? Live! No.
pre-recorded live.
Hey, this is Spike from DRI, and you're watching The Forbidden Zone on Access Tucson.
Thank you very, very, very much. It's been a pleasure.
Hopefully everybody got all that shit. So much fun for you guys. It's been our pleasure. It takes up a lot of time. Like I said, anybody that got any ideas, go to youtube.com, if I'm not mistaken. You guys can show whatever the hell you want to just videotape. There's a lot of crazy shit to be videotaped out there too, I'll tell you that right now. And I'm not, my recommendation is to like dick up on a like totally fucking videotaping. We're talking crazy shit. But there's a minimum. Everybody knows there's a limit. So you guys just have fun out there fucking YouTubing all that shit. Go to Movie Collectors Music Show, you'll be able to like see more of our shit. Hopefully everybody enjoyed all the footage that you guys saw tonight of my TV show. We had DRI interviewed. It wasn't much, but it was, you know, for you guys to see what the hell we've been doing out here. That DRI, I think, was from 2000, if I'm not mistaken. Last fucking concert I saw over there in Tucson, all of a sudden I just like tapped into the webpage. It was like, look, we want to like videotape the show. I got a fucking ticket already for the concert, so I'm already going to be in there, but is it okay if I can like show you guys on my TV show? And fucking Spike Cassidy was like, can you videotape the whole fucking concert, and if you can possibly catch up to us, you can do an interview and show it on your TV show. Fucking A. So, hopefully everybody enjoyed all that footage from DRI, Dirty Rotten Imbeciles. Go to the web pages, go to the MySpaces, go to YouTube. You'll be able to see more DRI footage with me and them guys over there at fucking Rialto Theater, believe it or not, from over here out in fucking Joliet, Illinois. Same thing over there, Rialto, over there at Tucson. But they played over there and we were able to like videotape them live. It was fucking fun. They were like one of the baddest bands in my fucking entire life. Had the pleasure of fucking videotaping. Didn't really even know what I got myself into until it was already done, because I felt like so stupid. I feel stupid sometimes seeing this stupid, the interview of like when I was interviewing him. I mean, so fucking gay and bogus. Like, it's not gay, like homosexual gay, but it was just like, dude, I could have had a bitter fucking shit to talk about to him, or something to say. But, yeah, that was 2000. YouTube, man, you guys go to YouTube. We're all over the fucking place. Movie Collectors Music Show, I think you want to go to. I don't even know what to say about the guys in Tucson anymore. What the hell? I mean, what the hell happened here? Almost seems like we just fucking just all just like went our ways. Pretty soon they're gonna give me some information on how to get a hold of them guys in Tucson, Arizona. My roots. So it's pretty cool that, you know, I always got to remember, you know, the, where the hell you come from. I think that's it with DRI, huh? No more. Hopefully everybody enjoyed tonight. That was from 2000, DRI, Dirty Rotten Imbeciles, fucking interview with me and Spike Cassidy. Fucking badass. YouTube.com. Go to Movie Collectors Music Show, people out there, okay? Watch more of our shit. Last show, top 5 moments. Hopefully everybody enjoyed it tonight. Cut down to the best time. We had, I don't know, a lot of shit, but I had a lot of shit to fucking choose from, so it was fucking pretty fucking fun. Last show, top 5 moments. Hopefully everybody enjoyed it. Love you guys. We're all over fucking YouTube anymore now, so you guys, check us out. Movie Collectors Music Show is where you want to go to, right? Fucking type MOVIE Collectors, Collectors, Music Show, MUSICSHOW. I feel like I'm singing the Mickey Mouse song when I was saying that right now. But Movie Collectors Music Show is where you want to go to. YouTube, check us out. We're still there. We're live twitching. We'll want to be over here for you guys for Tucson anymore, but this is it. Probably to the very bitter end, right? we're like stretching it. We're like fucking pushing to the last fucking minute. This is it. You know, it would be a fucking miracle if I could come back to you guys and talk to you guys again. Anybody who left me out there, thank you very much. Appreciate it. You know, beautiful women out there in Tucson, Arizona, University of Arizona. Marty, no shit. Marty, Chris and Ray for dragging me down there to fucking downtown to begin with. If it wasn't for them guys, holy fuck, it wouldn't have been 500 shows later, I don't think. But I guess now we're YouTube, so go to Movie Collectors Music Show. Movie Collectors Music Show once again. Marty, you guys rock. This has been for you guys and shit, dude. For all, we want to dedicate this whole fucking show to you guys tonight. You can see it. Movie Collectors Music Show. Go to YouTube. You can see this whole show. This has been the last show, top five moments. DRI, hopefully you guys enjoyed that shit. Fucking A, this is it. See you guys probably tomorrow. Bye.